Alright, welcome back to Let's Play Kingdom Hearts. I almost said Let's Play Kingdom Hearts 2, but this is not Kingdom Hearts 2, this is Kingdom Hearts 1. So we're gonna head back to the Colosseum and finish off that part of the game. Even if we don't have any more healing items, which we may, I'm gonna have to go back and check. I think you actually have to input which items you're gonna keep in your... Now that I'm playing through this again, I'm starting to realize what's going on here. I'm starting to think maybe I have to assign it to the item slot. Which I had known that before I would have done that at the Olympus Coliseum the first time. I forget all the little conveniences that come with modern gaming, because even if this is a remastered version, I mean, there's still so many issues with it that you just don't have with new games. It's time to fight Fluffy again. Cerberus, Fluffy, you know what I mean. We'll drop in at the Colosseum gates. Oh, is there a red Trinity out here, maybe? Maybe not. So now we're gonna save here. Wait, maybe I'll wait. Okay. Yep, I have to... Stop. There we are. So I had probably at least one or two potions this entire time, and I didn't realize it because I didn't realize I have to stalk these guys. And then, if this is really needed, we have a Mega Potion. Alright, let's go out. Oh, wait, nope, we're gonna wait one more time because I just realized that, we need the Jungle King key. There we go. Alright, now we leave. I am not afraid. And we're skipping the cutscene because all you need to know is that Herc was holding Cloud and then he ran. Oh, and we actually have Cure now, so this is even less of an issue. So, I mean, we don't even really have to worry about how many times we get hit anymore, because between the cure spell and the potions and stuff, like, we are sitting pretty. Alright, fine. We'll do the avoid dance. And if they're already actually vomiting darkness, then we're okay. We're doing pretty well. Come on, just... I don't want to kill the doggy, but the doggy needs to be defeated. Vomit darkness again. Yas. God damn it, stop vomiting darkness. Be a good dog. How hard is that to be just a good dog? I need to grow a cure in my shortcuts. There we go. I didn't even have to use any healing items or anything that time.
Thus, I do hereby dub the Junior Heroes and confer upon thee full rights and privileges to participate in the games. Further...
Hey, what do you mean, Junior Heroes?
You rookies still don't understand what it takes to be a true hero.
So, what does it take?
Well, that's just something you'll have to find out for yourselves. Just the way that I did.
No problem. We'll start by proving ourselves in the games.
There ain't gonna be any games for a while. Gotta clean up the mess from that last battle first.
Okay, we'll be back.
I still can't believe that Squirt actually beat Cerberus.
Just between us, I'd already worn Cerberus down by the time the little guy jumped in.
My lips are sealed.
Alright, I thought we would get... So, I'll have to remember. I have no plans on doing the games, by the way. But once we have the Yellow Trinity, we'll need to move this. Because that is where we find the keyhole for this world, and it's best if we... Oh, wait, there's Cloud.
Hey, are you alright?
Yeah.
So, why did you go along with him anyway?
I'm looking for someone. Hades promised to help. I tried to exploit the power of darkness, but it backfired. I fell into darkness, and I couldn't find the light.
You'll find it. I'm searching too.
before your light? Don't lose sight of it.
How about a rematch sometime? Fair and square, no dark powers involved.
I think I'll pass.
Alright, so I actually want to go back into abilities. Where the hell? Why can't I see, like the overall health meter? Like, what does it take to get that? Whatever.
He's strong. He's kind. He's always there for you. And he's handsome to boot. He's perfect. Perfect.
Perfectly infuriated! He makes me crazy!
Wait a minute. What are you worried about? All the pieces are in place. Relax. Whoa, 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 whoa. Here's what you do. Let Hercules train the kid. In the next games, I'll take care of them both. Who invited you to the party? Stay out of this. This is my show.
As you wish. Fight to your heart's content.
So the thing is, to wrap up that storyline, you have to fight in the Hades Cup, and the Hades Cup is a fucking bitch. And I just don't really have any intention of finishing that storyline. Unless I'm wrong and misremembering, in which case it's like a quick visit back, maybe another boss battle, and then, you know, you're done. But otherwise, I'm just going to wait until we have the Yellow Trinity, go back and seal that world. This music, the gummy shit music, isn't bad by any means. I actually kind of like it, but like, it's the same music no matter where you're traveling to, and it does get old by the end of the game. It's like, stop, please, no more. No more of this music. And I just don't really have a whole lot to say in these parts, because unlike the later games, which have a lot of stuff to talk about, Kingdom Hearts, the first Kingdom Hearts game, is actually fairly straightforward in that you are a chosen one looking for your friends, and you're traveling to different Disney worlds, essentially experiencing some variation of their own storyline. You know, lather, rinse, repeat. Throwing some Sora, Donald, Goofy, and like, it's perfect. Like, that's, you're done. So we're gonna go ahead and head to the accessory shop again. Oh, and there's a Moogle. Big tournament is being held somewhere. So, which Trinity did I learn apart from the green ones again? Or not the green ones, the blue ones. It was the red ones, right? So let's talk. And we have Moogles here now. There's a letter outside the second district as well shop. Cool. Ah, the view, it's so beautiful, Kubo. Oh, wait, I think with this one we can open that treasure chest now by putting out these. Why did that one light up again?
See ya!
Oh, there. So now apparently we want to find Leon, right? So here's Yuffie. Leon's probably at the underground cavern. He trains there often. You know, the channel in the alleyway is connected to the cavern. So I'm actually curious if we can just open up this. Yes, it's the red one, we should be able to. Thank God. Okay, come on, just, come on, you can grab on. You can grab on, and you can sew. All you have to do is reach your hand up a little bit. Come on. So I have to go the long way around because Sora doesn't know how to reach his arm up. So then we go through here. Waste our time. I'm not dealing with these things right now. This is what I was talking about when I said sometimes I will just get tired of fighting enemies and I'm not gonna do it anymore. So this is kind of what that looks like. And which door do I fucking take? Alright, now we'll go into the red room. And there's a treasure chest here that I want. I think the alleyway is the way I want. But first, pretty stone. So we go into the alleyway. Why was he... I'm curious, actually, now that I'm thinking about it. Why was Squall's name changed to Leon? I never actually finished Final Fantasy VIII. I think I only finished the first disc of it, but I'm curious. So you found the keyhole. Yeah. The keyblade locked it automatically. Good. So every world among the stars has a keyhole, and each one leads to the heart of that world. There must be one in this town as well. What do you mean? It was in Ansem's report. The Heartless enter through the keyhole and do something to the world's core. What happens to the world? It ends and it disappears. Then it disappears. What? That's why your key is so important. Please lock the keyholes. You're the only one who can. I don't know. Seeing other worlds would probably serve you well. Yeah. We gotta find your friends in King Mickey. I guess you're right. Okay. And he's pretty easily convinced, but that still doesn't help us with the gummy ship piece. Hey, Leon. This gummy block's different from the others. Do you know what it's for? Ask Sid. He should know. Wait, Sora, take this with you. Earthshine. This stone holds some mysterious power. I've been carrying it for luck. I want you to hold on to it. How do you use it? I like that he goes completely silent when he doesn't know the answer. It's cute. So, this, I feel like there was something that you can do over here with this, like, moon mural. I don't remember what it is. Maybe it's a cutscene later. I don't know. I saw no evidence of anything going on up there at all, so I don't really get what that was for. We saw the keyholes, yes, yes. And so that brings me another question. If Aqua, Ventus, and Terra were so concerned about this, why didn't they lock the other worlds? Is it, can we assume that it was just something that became a necessity recently? Is that why? I mean, they did have the lanes between, and then those that weren't open or connected weren't part of those lanes, and those worlds couldn't technically be accessed directly. Actually, not anything about that. So, well, no, wait, that does work because Xehanort was able to get to Destiny Island because that was his home. Oh, and I didn't realize the time. Alright, so I'm gonna end this part. Thank you for watching, and I will see you.